Good day everybody, welcome back. This lesson we are going to talk about the rudder, and under rudder we are going to talk about a subtopic, forces. And in the next lecture we are going to talk about the construction of the rudder and the features of the rudder. But in this lecture we are going to talk about the forces acting on this rudder, and because of these forces acting, what will be the effect created on the ship by this rudder. So if you look if you look at the shape of the rudder in just a cross section, if you look at the shape of the rudder, this is the shape of the rudder which is now you can see in this in the ships, this kind of shape you can see in the ships, which is called the hydrofoil shape. This shape is called hydrofoil, and if you look very closely, that this shape has a similarity to aircraft wings, so but not exactly, but there is a similarity. This shape is there in aircraft wing also. In the aircraft wing, that shape is called aerofoil shape, but since the rudder is acting on liquid, this shape is called hydrofoil shape. So why this shape? Why what is the significance of this shape? So we look at why it is like this. So why, in the first place, why do we need a rudder to a ship? The rudder is the item which will act as the steering mechanism for the ship. So by using this rudder we can turn the ship, but you will see later on actually how this turning is happening. Is it the rudder or is it something else that the ship is getting turned by? But in for the time being, we'll just assume that the rudder is there to turn the ship. So so let's look at the flow of the water around this rudder. So if this is my ship, if this is the ship, and if this is the rudder, in this case I will be drawing the rudder a bit larger just for the explanation, but you will be not getting rudders like this, a ship like this, and you will be not getting a rudder like this. But this is exaggerated just to show you that the flow of the water, right? So in this case, the flow of the water, now the rudder is in midship condition. You can see, if you look at the rudder angle indicator, this is 0 degrees, so it is in midship condition, and the flow of the water will be nicely going around this rudder. So the rudder is behind the propeller, so propeller is somewhere here and the rudder is somewhere here, and there is a reason for that. You will see later on why is that. So this is the shape of the rudder, and there will be a nice flow. But why this shape? Why not like in olden days, why the rudder is not, why the rudder is not something like this, just a piece of a flap, kind of a flap, right? Why it is not like this, but why it is like this? You will see when I apply, when the angle is applied to the rudder. For example, let's say this is the ship's head, and a certain rudder angle is applied now. When we apply this rudder angle, right, so it is a starboard rudder, you can see that. Now what will happen, we go back to the same theory of two water molecules passing from the sides. If you can remember in the first lecture, this was explained. Here what we do is we are putting two water molecules here. As the ship is moving forward, what will happen, this water molecule will, one water molecule will follow this path and come over here, and this water molecule will follow this path and come over here. As explained in the first lecture, these two water molecules will be meeting each other. Otherwise, they will be, if they are separated, As you know, please go back to the, if you do not understand this part, you have to first go through the first lecture, then you will understand what I am saying. If there is a separation between these two water molecules, there will be turbulence, which we do not want near the rudder at the end. Right? Anyway, the rudder is experiencing turbulence because of the propeller. Propeller is creating a propeller wash, and because of the propeller wash, the rudder is always experiencing turbulence. But at the same time, when the flow is occurring and at this place, at the tip of the rudder, we do not need much turbulence. So this is not going to happen. Turbulence is not going to happen most of the time. These two water molecules will meet each other at the same time. So when they meet each other at the same time, so that means the time taken from here to here for the traveling, both water molecules take same time period. Otherwise, there will be separation, right? So, when they are taking the same time period, so if you look at the left-hand side water particle, what about the distance that this water particle is traveling compared to the distance traveled by this water particle? You can see easily that because of this shape, because of this hydrophile shape, this water particle, because of this shape only, right? Because of this shape only, this is happening. So that is why this shape is significant. So when the angle is given in the rudder, this water particle had to travel. It has to travel further distance compared to this water molecule. So this water molecule is traveling more distance compared to this water molecule. And that means within the same time period. So the velocity of this water molecule compared to this water molecule, it is obvious that since this is traveling more distance but within the same time period, this has to travel faster compared to here, this one. So this is traveling very fast compared to, so V2 in this case, V2 is more than V1, right? Now we go back to the Bernoulli's theory, and in the Bernoulli's theory we came into two conclusions. For the first conclusion is that velocity increases, pressure drops. So this is also explained in, again this is explained in the first lecture. Please go back to the first lecture if you haven't gone through that one, then only we understand what I am saying, that velocity increases, pressure drops. So here the velocity is more compared to here, so velocity increases. When the velocity is getting increased, pressure is going to drop on this side. Comparatively, the other side is a high pressure system. So in this side you have a low pressure system, and in this side you have a comparatively a high pressure system. Now what will happen? High pressure to low pressure, there will be a push, right? There will be a push. So this push is the force acting into this direction. There will be force acting into this direction, right? Which is not in line or perpendicular to the ship's head, but it is perpendicular to the rudder center line, right? So there will be a force created, and this is the total force acting now on the rudder. So because of this force only, the ship is going to turn, right? Because of this force only, the ship is going to turn. So you can see that the force is getting created, this force is getting created by the pressure difference on the side of the rudder. This pressure difference is getting created by this shape of the rudder. Why is that? Again, I will explain the previous concept. You can see there are two water molecules. One water molecule travel from this side, and the other one is traveling from this side. Before the when the ship was not there, these two water molecules were together. We separated that one by the rudder itself. And this is traveling faster because the distance it has to travel is more compared to this side. Because these two had to, it has to meet each other at the same time at the same location. Otherwise, there will be separation and there will be turbulence. So accordingly, this shape has a significant value to create this high pressure and low pressure. Because of this pressure difference, there will be a force acting, and by this force only the ship is going to turn. So now look at the forces. What are the forces? In the next lecture, we are going to look again much more in detail what are the forces acting on the rudder. So we will go to the next lecture. In the next lecture, we will be looking at these forces. Thank you.